Hello, it's JD here and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Due to some busy schedule, after a long time I am posting a video on this channel, but this video is very helpful for you. As you remember, I was posted two videos, to convert legacy BIOS to UEFI BIOS without any data loss, and this videos helps lots of my subscribers. If you want to watch this videos, you can watch it by simply tapping on the I button. But at the another side, some of my subscribers are not able to convert the legacy BIOS to UEFI BIOS, due to some technical reason, so don't worry, I am back with another method, to convert legacy BIOS to UEFI BIOS without any data loss. So watch the complete video and follow every steps carefully, because if you missed any steps, your system becomes unbootable. Please note that, before performing this operation, please make sure your system support UEFI BIOS. For reference, you can refer your system motherboard manufacturer website. If your system does not support UEFI BIOS, please don't try to convert it, otherwise, it will make your system unusable. Now let's move to our main topic. For your satisfaction, I am going to show you my system BIOS mode, as well as the data stored on my system's hard drive. As you can see here, in my case the BIOS mode is legacy mode. Now let me show you the stored data on this system hard disk. As you can see here, I have stored lots of data on the current hard drive, which we are going to convert it to UEFI BIOS mode. So let's start. So first we have to download the software. To download it, simply open web browser and search for the Almei Partition Assistant. Now click on the free Partition Manager link under the diskpart.com. Here, click on Download Freeware. Once you clicked on it, you'll redirect it to the new page. Again, click on the Download Freeware button. Now the Almei Partition Assistant start downloading. After downloading, follow the next steps. We have to install the Almei Partition Assistant tool. To install it, simply double-click on the setup file. Click on OK, and head over to install it. Click on Skip. Finally, click on Install Now. The Almei Partition Assistant will be installed in a while. Now open the Almei Partition Assistant tool. As you can see here, Convert to GPT option is available in Pro version of the Almei Partition Assistant, which mean we have to pay for it. But don't worry friends, I am going to gift you a key to all of my subscribers and new members. This is a first giveaway to my YouTube family. To get the key, simply go to the link of this video description, or you can also get this link from my Telegram channel. Once you grab the license key, simply click on Register. Here you have to paste the key, or you can enter it manually. Once you entered the keys, simply click on Register. During registration process, please make sure your system has connected to the internet. As you can see here, the activation is successful. Now click on OK. Now we are ready to use this feature to convert legacy to UEFI. Now select the disk on which the OS has been installed. After selecting the correct system disk, simply click on Convert to GPT. Now a confirmation pop-up will appear like this. Here click on OK. Again a warning pop-up will be opened, which is advise you to proceed to next steps only if your system supports UEFI BIOS. If your system does not support UEFI BIOS, Please don't try to convert it. If you do that, your system not able to boot next time. If you are 100% sure, your system supports UEFI BIOS, then click on Yes. Click on Apply. Now click on Proceed. Here select Restart in pre-OS mode, and click on OK. During this process system will be restarted to perform some operations, so please be patient. In some cases system will be shows error like this, don't worry we will fix it. To fix this, simply press the Ctrl, Alt, and Delete keys at the same time, or restart your system, we need to configure some settings, in BIOS. To enter in BIOS mode, there are specific hotkeys, for different motherboard manufacturer. Once you've entered in BIOS, simply navigate to the Startup tab. Here select Primary Boot Sequence, and press Enter key. Now find and select the hard drive, it is located in the SATA section. We need to set the R hard drive to the first position, so the R system able to boot from it. To do that, simply select hard drive from the list, and press the plus key on the keyboard, until the hard drive reaches to the top of this list. As you can see here, the hard drive is moved at the first position. Now press Escape key. Here select Automatic Boot Sequence, and press Enter key. Again here we have to set the hard drive to first position, to do that, repeat the same steps, which we follows in previous steps. After doing that, press Escape key again. Now select the Error Boot Sequence, and press Enter key. Again set the hard drive to the first position. Now press Escape key. Here find and select the CSM, or legacy, and press Enter key. Select Enabled, and press Enter key. Now save the changes, by pressing F10 key on the keyboard. Finally, select Yes and press Enter key. Some operations are still pending, so our system will restarting to complete it, so please be patient, and don't press any keys during operation. To better understanding, I am not fast forwarding the video. As you can see here, the conversion process will start in some second, please don't press any key. If you press the keys, the operation will be aborted, and system becomes unbootable. The operation is now started, maybe it will take a while, so wait for it. Once you see message like this, then press Enter key to restart the system, or it will be restarted automatically in 10 seconds. Now the R system is restarting. After successful operation, the first time, system will take some time to boot, so please don't panic. Right now, the video is fast forwarded, in my case, it takes 10 to 15 minutes to be completed. As you can see here, the system is booted successfully. Now let me log in it to check, BIOS is converted from legacy to UEFI or not, and our data is still there or deleted. As you can see here, the BIOS is successfully converted from legacy to UEFI. Now let's check our data is still there or deleted. As you can see here, our data is still here. So friends, if this video is helpful for you, then like and share this video, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Check out this cool videos for your tech problems.